So one of the big probably challenges in kind of using vector databases in machine learning applications is updating embeddings, right? So you change a model, you need to basically update the entire index. Is there any breakthroughs like of being able to maybe do that in place and maybe creating a new version of already existing index in place and just commit it at some point in time so that you don't need to create a new one?
You know, that's always a tough question. We actually get this question a lot. Now, typically, if you use a vector database, you'll have an embedding model that you want to use in mind. And that embedding model hopefully won't change for a period of time. If you do get a V2 or a V3 of that embedding model, yes, you will have to reindex everything. There are ways around that. So for example, if I have an original domain of data and that domain of data is good for a very specific embedding, you know, that my embedding model fits that domain of data, and I want to extend, now all of a sudden I have a new domain of data and I want to train a new embedding model over that, right? I have two separate, you know, I want to combine that with my original data domain of data. What I can do is I can train a new model that learns to mimic the embeddings of the old model. Yeah, I can, you know, I have some type of L2 loss. I train a model that learns to mimic the embeddings of my old model over the old domain of data while still providing me with useful, relevant information, relevant embeddings for my newer domain of data, right? If I just have a pure upgrade in terms of embedding model, I like one embedding model is much better than the other over very, very wide domain of data, you know, you will have to re-index everything in your vector database. That's the unfortunate reality of it. There might be some tricks that we could use. So, you know, maybe we could train some sort of, some sort of encoder. We could train some sort of multi-layer perceptron to map old embeddings to new embeddings, but I would still have to, you know, I would have to embed that into my vector database. You know, things become a little more complicated. But long story short, yeah, if you have a pure upgrade for your for your data and you have a completely new model, you unfortunately will have to reindex a lot of data. If instead what you're looking at is maybe potentially I have a new domain of data and I want to be able to extend my old domain of data to this new domain of data as well, I can simply apply some sort of L2 loss to make sure that my old domain of data is there in line with my new domain too.
I can imagine having like optimized such a cost function and do it like that, but I'm skeptical about the performance here because it would also mean that we are like that the new model will be using a very similar feature space. Otherwise, element of vector, like if you can use the same feature space, then it sounds feasible that it should work. But if your problem requires or would like you would get significantly better performance if you can use different features, like the your model will figure out what those features will represent. But I think it is, yeah, for some use cases, I think it can work, but
I totally agree with you. And that's what I'm saying. I think if you have like a new domain of data and you want, If you have all this old data that you've built an embedding model across, and all of a sudden you have this new data, and that new data is a different domain, right? It's, let's say your old data is all financial documents and your new data is all legal documents. And you want a new model that can handle all those documents together. Then, you know, it makes sense. I think it makes sense to apply this loss to do some sort of to use the old model as a teacher, you know, in some way, shape, and form. And if you have, the reason is because, you know, at the end of the day, these embedding spaces are not, they're not spherical. They're not spherical in these high dimensions. They're very, very anisotropic. And they, you know, if we could visualize 768 dimensions, right? You know, you can imagine we do T-SNE or UMAP and we sort of shave them down to three dimensions so that we can visualize them. They're like very, very oblong and they're very oddly shaped, and there might be like a cluster here in this embedding space. and like a different, you know, a bigger cluster here in this embedding space. We, you know, they're not spherical in high dimensions. And that's why we have, that's why if you have a totally new domain of data, I think it's possible. I haven't actually tried, so, you know, don't take my word for it. But that's why I think it's possible to sort of have a new embedding model that handles all of your data together, not just your old data, but also your new data. If that's assuming that your data is, that you have different domains. Getting pretty deep in ML here, but I imagine there is some research about this. I guarantee you there's research about this. I'm like 99.9% sure there's research about this. I just haven't read any papers associated with it. You know, for anybody who's listening, if you are aware of some research, you know, feel free to reach out to me. I'd love to sort of go through some of those papers as well. But it's an open problem for sure. It's definitely an open problem.